Ain't nothing to fear now.
That's what scares me. Stay here.
We're about to get paid.
With all these awesome collectibles and memorabilia avalanches taking us by storm. Anyway, tonight's episode is an extra special one since we've been waiting for this piece for what seemed like forever. He was announced when we first started our show. Damn! Anyway, where is he? There he is, Hot Toys' latest DX05 1/6 scale Indiana Jones and the Raiders of the Lost Ark figure. Definitely a worthy character for DX treatment. Starting with the packaging, Hot Toys DX series figures are considered the upper tier figures, and their packaging definitely reflects that. First off, you get a beautifully styled 5-panel swing lid box with a textured logo and Indy's fedora and whip on the front. The rest of the surfaces are meticulously designed to look weathered, and it works very well. All of the obvious Sideshow and Hot Toys logos are also present. Opening the magnetic side flap, the first thing you see is a brief summary of the film and an Indiana graphic on the inside flap. The first layer in the box has a life-size Ark of the Covenant discovery map, which is a very cool, unexpected extra. Next layer down, we finally see the man himself, Indiana Jones, aka Harrison Ford, in his much younger years. Also on that same layer, we get a load of accessories. Next layer down, we get more accessories and environment pieces. Still another layer down, we get more environment pieces and accessories, and finally, underneath it all, we get the environment backdrops. We really can't express how hefty this set is and how well presented this packaging is. Every part has its own dedicated slot in high quality foam, or it's sealed in a clamshell case or plastic baggie. Nothing moves around in the box and has excellent protection on top of just plain old looking beautiful. DX figures definitely get the royal treatment, but let's get this set cracking. Starting off with Indy himself, the base figure is of the newer style with a rubber torso. He does only have single jointed elbows and a single ball jointed neck. Overall, his articulation is pretty good at 31 points. Again, no feet, but at least he got the four-way shoulders. Starting off with his garments, Indy is wearing a pair of tan boxers and black half socks, since they have no feet ends. Next, he is wearing a pair of beautifully weathered faux leather ankle boots with authentic laces that are apparently glued in place. But you can pop the calves out of the boot joints, so no problem there. Next, Indy is wearing a pair of tan khaki pants with functional front pockets. They're held up with a brown fabric belt with a working gold loop buckle. Up top, he's wearing a long sleeve, button-down collared shirt with pleats and decorative breast pockets. On top of it all, Indiana Jones is fitted with an awesome faux leather jacket with functional flap pockets, adjustable waist straps, and an authentic zipper. We're not sure if the zipper actually functions, but we don't plan on attempting to try it out. Finally, Indy has an awesome functional inside pocket on the left side of his jacket. Very cool. Indy's head sculpt, which was done by Arnie Kim, seems to be questionable among the collecting community. There does seem to be something off somewhere, but it's really hard to put your finger on it. We think it may have something to do with the overall shape of the head and the awkward neck socket, which cuts into the jaw dramatically. An extra articulation point at the base of the neck would have drastically helped here, in our opinions. But overall, there's no doubt that you're looking at Harrison Ford's portrait. It just appears a small percentage off in some unidentifiable way. That being said, the paint job is excellent. Indy's hair is removable to operate the parallel eye rolling system, which works much smoother than any of our other DX models, and is also switchable with his other hair accessory in order for Indy to wear his fedora. Indy's fedora is well sculpted and fits nice and snug. The actual fabric band and bow is also a very nice touch. Indiana Jones is loaded with accessories. First off, you get the standard nut hugger stand. Then, check this out, you get his authentic, that's right, authentic leather whip, partially wire-lined for mid-action positioning. You also get his revolver pistol with working hammer and deployable cylinder. You also get the matching magnetic holster and full leather adjustable belt with additional magnetic whip harness. Next, you get his .45 automatic pistol with working hammer, removable clip, and full cocking action. You also get Indiana's man purse with separate inner compartments, an adjustable shoulder strap, metal loops, grommets, and a magnetic flap. And there's more! You also get Indy's working drawstring pouch with metal grommets and his journal with individual authentic sheets of paper. Of course, you get two extra pair of nude hands and an additional two pairs of gloved hands to simulate Indy in different poses and holding his accessories. If that ain't enough, you get a second set of garments to simulate Indiana disguised as an Arab, consisting of the beige robe with sash and the head wrap with scarf. And to top it off, you get the Staff of Ra to reenact the map room scene. The last major component to this set is the environment and its accessories. Indiana Jones comes packaged with probably the best DX environment yet. You get the double-sided, three-panel diorama backdrop and raised base with metallic DX05 nameplate. One side to simulate the map room environment and the other side to simulate the fertility idol chamber. In addition to this, you get the fertility idol pedestal and an electroplated golden fertility idol. No electronic features, but in this environment, it's fairly understandable. Now to conclude this episode, we will say we are in love with this set. While Jay still says the DX04 exclusive, which was two complete figures, is still the clear ultimate DX set to date, Indiana is arguably a strong contender for third place, with the DX01 being second, with virtually two figures out of the box. The sheer amount of accessories, wardrobe options, and environment possibilities included with Indy are staggering. A second head would have made the 05 an arguable second place contender in the DX series, because a second figure would be possible with an extra true type. Overall, this piece feels like a bit of price tag relief, being only slightly more than the Shadow Predator and the latest Bruce Wayne Batsuit Begins releases. The critical customers will probably have likeness issues. However, anyone who says it doesn't look anything like Harrison Ford is flat out exaggerating. Still very pricey, the DX05 Indiana Jones is a long-merited character deserving DX treatment, and the set as a whole is clearly at the top of the Hot Toys manufacturing heap. If you can swing them and you like the character, you'll probably love this set. Peace out, guys.